Hey everybody, I am back here with my second haul that I ever have done from Haley's Heavenly Scents. I got this when Janet was running that incredible sale. I don't know if it was like about a month ago. Pretty much she just had like different cutoffs, but you know, monetarily. So if you spent $25, you might have gotten like one free bag of scallops. And if you spent $50, it might have been two bags of scallops. I know that if you went over $100, you got 2 1-pound bags of brittle and then 3 bags of scallops for free. And then everything was also 15% off and it was free shipping. So, I mean, I was like sitting there scratching my head. I'm like, is she making any profit off of this at all? Like, I wasn't really sure, but I was like, well, then she wouldn't make a sale so good. She wasn't making profit, right? So, I had heard a lot of really good things about Haley's Heavenly Scents, and I saw this as an opportunity to really stock up, especially on some fall pumpkin, apple, winter type scents that I had my eye on, along with a million other things. So I kind of just put in a big order. So this is stressing me out because one thing you guys probably realize, it takes work to prep these videos. You know, I have to remove all the ties, I have to get the scent descriptions printed out, and then I have to alphabetize it or put it in order that the scent descriptions go in vaguely. So I'm a little stressed because I have some out here, but I'll let you know right now. I've got 49 different scents in this haul, I think, 49. And I also did place a second order from her, and that one I don't know what it was, but I can tell you total between both orders I placed with Haley's Heavenly Scents, it was 76 different scents. Some of them were like the free ones, but I like printed out all the scent descriptions. So it was a lot. So I kind of have a lot to get through, so I should stop talking. The turnaround time I thought was really good. I knew she had taken a lot of orders. I knew there were a lot of really big ones in there. And on her Facebook group page today, she seemed to insinuate that some people were complaining. I mean, I don't know what people out there expect. I mean, you got to wait for the wax, and especially when somebody does a ginormous sale like that, probably one of the best sales of the year for any wax vendor, that it's going to be a little crazy, and obviously the turnaround time is going to go up. So I have no problem with the turnaround time. I'm still waiting on my second part of my order. It's all good. It's all good in the hood. You know, I don't really care. I do think there was one mistake that was made, and it was this bag of Hello Kitty tarts. I didn't realize it until after I kind of already ripped it open, and it's not like I'm going to contact her and say I got the wrong bag of tarts or like whatever, or try to figure out whose it was. I mean, it's one bag of tarts, you know, but if somebody really, if this was yours and you want it, I guess you could let me know, but I already opened it, I'm gonna touch all the wax. All right, anyways, I do wanna point out that when she does her bag, she puts this really cute curling ribbon on each bag, but she also does close every single bag with a twist tie. So I do really like that aspect because I'm not a big fan of the curling ribbon. Yes, it makes it look cute, I like it in that aspect, but it's not like I'm going to be able to retie all my bags with a curling ribbon really easily. So pretty much now it looks cute. I got rid of the curling ribbon. That's going to go in the trash, and the twist ties are going to come back on here at the end. Okay, so I'm just going to go through these one by one. So it's going to be a long one, and this is probably a good video to put on if you just need background noise for like a long time. A long time. So pretty much everything I got were the bags of scallops. I did get a couple bags of some other things. This one has a lot of oil in it. You can see all the extra oil. So this one here is an absolutely fabulous cake is what this one is. And she says this is rich, moist white cake with hints of silky white chocolate and sweet cream, shredded toasted coconut coated with sweet vanilla nestled inside. Also topped off with mounds of sweet buttercream icing. Oh, there's oil on this top one too. I'm getting like my fingers are getting all dirty. It's definitely very super duper sweet. This is probably the sweetest of the bakery that I like to go personally. I don't want to go any sweeter than this. I can smell the coconut. Not a huge fan of the coconut scent in here. But if you guys are looking for like an absolutely fabulous cake with some coconut in there, this one I think is definitely the one for you. I'm definitely interested to look at the oil on my finger. I'm definitely interested to see like what this one is going to smell like when it's hot, if the coconut's going to be like really predominant or if it's going to kind of go away a little bit. Anyways, I have a feeling that the rest of this haul is going to smell like coconut, so let me go wash my hands. All right, hands washed. Can't have that oil on my fingers this entire time since I'm touching everything else, so it kind of makes smelling a little bit difficult. So this next one here that I got was some scallops in I need to figure out how I want to do this video. These tarts are like driving me crazy here. Stay in the bag. Are these scallop tarts here in aloe vera. So this one is a green, this one here is a green floral bouquet with sweet wood and a musk background. It's definitely very musky, very kind of like, yeah, woodsy, kind of masculine, but with like a feminine twist a little bit with the floral. It's really nice. I think there might be like a honeysuckle scent in there from the floral scent, but yeah, I do like that one. That's kind of nice. This next one here, this is me getting into my fall scents that I wanted to get. This one is Apple Orchard Ice Cream Dough, Ice Cream Scoop Dough Bread. This is Apple Orchard and Ice Cream Scoop Dough Bread. I guess that makes sense. I'm sorry, I'm really out of practice with filming haul videos. I feel like I've been an idiot this whole time. It's definitely a really fresh red apple scent. Slightly perfumey, but mostly just a really good authentic apple scent. I cannot smell... Oh no, I can smell the ice cream scoop dough bread. But on cold, it's definitely harder to smell that. It's mostly just an apple scent when it's cold. This next one here is Blue Raspberry Cotton Candy, I think. Yep. Blue Raspberry Cotton Candy. This is fruity notes of raspberry and strawberry blended with a sweet, rich vanilla, sticky, and sweet spun sugar on a stick. This one I'm actually having a hard time smelling on cold. I'm not getting a whole lot of this on cold throw. I can smell the strawberry, and actually when I really smell it, and that is like a fresh picked strawberry scent to me in here. Don't smell any raspberry. And I can definitely just get like a really sweet scent, so that's obviously the cotton candy. So I'm definitely interested to melt that one. I hope that one throws really good when it's hot, because that's just like a really, really nice scent. Okay, this next one here is one that I did order, but I didn't mean to order this one. I don't know what I was trying to order unless I just threw it in my cart because it looked interesting. This one is Blue Cotton Candy, so I do not have the scent description. Mostly just cotton candy. The blue part, I don't know if that's like a blue raspberry or if that's supposed to be blue sugar. I don't really smell any blue sugar. I think that may be like a blue raspberry scent. But either way, that's another really good one, like that other one. It's just a really nice, fruity, but super sweet cotton candy type of scent. Okay, these bags are like piling up over here. Stay over there. Okay, this next bag is the one that I'm pretty sure I didn't order. I just checked my invoice. I didn't order any Hello Kitty heads. And I don't think I ordered this scent. This is cotton candy frosting. However, like I said, I did kind of sniff it, and it does smell really good. That smells just so good. The cotton candy frosting to me is like cotton candy on steroids. It's just pumped up, even more sweet. Oh, wow. That's really good. So I'm sorry, I don't know who that one belonged to, but that one is not mine, but I already opened it. I'm gonna put my fingers all over it. Okay, this next one here, sorry, this video is gonna be really crinkly. This next one here I got is cotton candy Twinkies. This one is a blend of cotton candy and Twinkies. Yep, okay, that sounds about right. Definitely stronger on the cotton candy, but you can tell that it's like a slightly creamier cotton candy, and I don't know if that's like the Twinkies, you know, maybe like the, like what is it? What's inside the Twinkies? Like that cream part of the Twinkies kind of coming out a little bit. Once again, on cold throw, I can't smell a whole lot. I don't know if my nose is kind of stuffed up today, but I'm having a hard time smelling these. Okay, this next one here is in Divine Cake, and Divine Cake is a white cake laced with marshmallow fluff, sweetened raspberries and strawberries, topped off with buttercream frosting. It's good, but it is slightly artificial, or there's an undertone to this one. No, there's not. I mean, no, there is. I'm not really sure what I'm picking up out of this one. I can definitely get the cake scent. I can smell the fruits. I wonder if it's the fruits that are throwing me off in here that I'm not expecting or something. Interesting. Just another really good fruity, very, very sweet scent. So, oh, all right. Let me find a place for, okay, I'm running out of room over here. Gonna have to do this video in like shifts. Okay, this next one here, I think this is Frosted Lime Cupcakes. And yup, it is. This is Persian Limes, Lemon zest, meringue, and royal vanilla icing and creamed cake. This one is absolutely a winner. I really haven't found a single lime that I do not like. I really like all of them. And this one it's zesty. I know they have lemon zest in here, but it's like a zesty lime. And then it's just like kind of tempered a little bit with those like creamy bakery notes. So this one is absolutely good. And that one is fairly strong on cold throw. I'm not having any problem smelling that one at all. Okay. This next one here, I think this is Grandma's Caramelized Crimson Pear. So my understanding with her Grandma's blends is that It's a zucchini bread scent, but it's a creamy zucchini bread. So I think anything with grandma's zucchini bread in it is creamy. And then anything you see that just says zucchini bread is her spicier one. I think I got a little bit of both. I'm not sure if I have them all in this haul. So this one should be the creamy one. So this is just caramelized crimson pear with grandma's zucchini bread. I really like it. Although on cold, I really can only smell the zucchini bread. And it's a really nice zucchini bread. Oh no, I can smell the pear. I can smell the pear. It's weird. I smell the top of the tart and I swear I can smell the zucchini bread, and I smell the bottom and I swear I can smell the pear more. But I mean, obviously it's all blended throughout, so I'm kind of going crazy. But I do like that, and that one does not have a weird scent. Sometimes like some fruits can kind of get a weird scent to me, but those both seem to be like kind of an authentic fruit scent. I like both of those. Okay, this next one here is bright red. So let me see if I know, what is this one? Grandma's Mrs. Claus Pink Noel. Why do I not have Grandma's Mrs. Claus Pink Noel? Oh, I do have that. Wait, Pink Noel Zucchini Bread. Yeah, this is Grandma's Zucchini Bread, Mrs. Claus's Cookies, Pink Sugar, and Vanilla Bean Noel. It's really good. It's really good. What I like in this one is, you guys already know if you watch my videos, I really like a really sweet zucchini bread. So I like the cookies and the zucchini bread in here. And then once you blend it with the Pink Sugar Vanilla Bean Noel, it's just really good. This is a blend that's similar to a lot of ones that I've had before. I think a fairly standard blend a lot of vendors carry is a Pink Sugar Vanilla Bean Noel and zucchini bread. And I really do love that blend. And I like this one too, with the addition of that Mrs. Claus's cookie. Kind of takes it to the next level, makes it a little bit more sweet. Okay, this next one here is Grandma's 7-Up Pound Cake. You guys can tell, not 7-Up Pound Cake. No, it is Grandma's 7-Up Pound Cake. So this one is Grandma's Zucchini Bread and 7-Up Pound Cake. I've never had 7-Up Pound Cake scents with zucchini bread. So I have to say, the 7-Up Pound Cake is stronger than the zucchini bread. And I'm not really sure if I like it, actually. I have to melt this one to see, but like it's 75% of that 7-Up Pound Cake scent, which is like a really nice kind of fizzy lemon lime scent, and like 25% zucchini bread is kind of what I'm sniffing in that one. Okay, this next one going on with it is Grandma's Pink Zucchini Bread. So I know I had Grandma's Mrs. Claus Pink Noel Zucchini Bread. So this one I'm assuming should just be zucchini bread, pink sugar, vanilla bean oil. Yeah, once again, this is good. You can tell that this one is not as sweet as that other one, the one that has the cookie in it, but it's still a blend that like I always just absolutely love. Okay, the next one is grape sugar milk. Sorry, I'm trying to get everything organized over here and it's like a total wreck. I'm really off in this video. How come I don't have a description for grape sugar milk on my little piece of paper over here? I must have missed that one. Oh, I can smell this already. This one's real strong on cold. You know, milk scents are always just interesting to me because they're milk scents. They always smell like a little burned, maybe. Something? I'm not really sure. I really like this. I've been really digging grape scents lately. I really like that. And the milk scent in here is just interesting. But I really, really like this one. This one is a, I'd say a surprise winner for sure. This one's some good stuff over there. Okay, now what have I not gone through over here? I think this is the last one for this segment, and then I'm gonna have to reorganize and get out the next one. So this one is Fluffy Pink Candy, and this one is Juicy Bubblegum Cotton Candy Juicy Apples Pears blended together with sugared candy lemon drops along with Madagascar Vanilla. Just super duper sweet, super fun, super girly. It kind of reminds me of like a juvenile girl, like something an 8-year-old would probably like, because it's just very fun and awesome and super cool and smells like boys. No, it doesn't smell like boys, but like boys have cooties. You can't, you know, boys and cooties. I don't know. I'm a little nutso over here. But yeah, anyways, that's kind of what that one smells like. Not my favorite. That kind of scent is just not my favorite in general. So I don't really know why I got that one, other than I think I just wanted to like branch out and get some other stuff. Okay, so I'm gonna go organize this and come back with the next round. Alrighty, everybody, continuing on here. The next one that I got is Hawaiian Sandalwood. This is a musky, soft, and wonderful fragrance oil. It's not as harsh as sandalwood, but has a touch of sweetness. So let me see what this smells like. It still smells like sandalwood, obviously. I think it is a little bit more delicate, a little bit more feminine than sandalwood, regular sandalwood. So I have to say, all in all, that one's a winner for sure, because I absolutely love sandalwood. So that one, yeah, that one is good to go. All right, this next one here is called Heavenly Scents. This is roses, cyclamens, and lemon blossom with hints of exotic woods. There is a lot of rose in here. I mean, obviously rose is in here, but it's definitely that like really kind of thick rose, which to me starts smelling like Play-Doh after too much time. But there is enough other stuff going on in here that I do overall still like it. I think the exotic woods is kind of what I'm picking up in there too. Oh man, I love woodsy scents and things like that, like masculine scents. Those to me are like an absolute favorite. Okay, the next one here is honeysuckle. And guess what it's supposed to smell like? Honeysuckle. So that's this one here. Yeah, that is honeysuckle. That is super strong, super potent honeysuckle. Oh my goodness, I love that one. I love putting on like a really strong floral fragrance every now and then. It kind of just like clears out your nose, or I don't know. I like honeysuckle. Okay, the next one here is key limed lemon pound cake, which is just a blend of lemon pound cake and key lime pie. And this one I did kind of get in the grubby scallops versus the fluted tarts, or the fluted scallops, whatever they're called. Oh, this one is really good. It's really, really good. I love lemon lime scents, and this one is kind of like, you can get like that freshness of both the lemon and the lime, but you still get like this overall very sweet scent of that pound cake. That's a really good one. Sometimes it's hard to do a good lemon lime bakery scent without it going like too strange on you. This next one here is lemon berry cake. This is strawberry, lemon chiffon, and white cake. And this is also in the, these kinds of grubbies here too. This is really good. This is really, really, really good. It smells like a fresh lemon. And the lemon is definitely stronger than the strawberry. But it's just like, it's mostly just a really good creamy bakery lemon scent. You can get the strawberry in there, but it blends really well with those other notes that is not like a super obvious strawberry. I don't know if that makes any sense here. Okay, this next one here is lemon poppy seed, and I got this in the, these are really cute shapes too. This kind of rose heart. And the one thing about about those shapes is that's like a perfect one size melt for me. I don't know how much this is. That looks to be maybe like an ounce and a half, maybe closer to 2 ounces, something like that, but I really like it. So lemon poppy seed is actually my favorite lemon, and I don't really know what the difference is between lemon poppy seed versus other lemons, but it seems universally I really like this one. Yeah, this is really nice. So this is the aroma of freshly baked lemon poppy seed muffins. It starts with candied lime, lemon syrup, bergamot extract, and then it has poppy seed muffin, brown sugar, and clove bud, base notes of marshmallow fluff, vanilla cake batter, and white musk. So there's a lot in here, but what I really love about lemon poppy seed scents in general is they're kind of like the perfect mix between like a cleaner lemon, a fresh lemon, and a bakery lemon. It's kind of like a lot of the lemons fall in like one of those three kinds of categories. This one seems to be like perfectly somewhere in the middle. Obviously less of a cleaner lemon, but imagine like the three of them doing like a tug of war, and like cleaner lemon is like losing a little bit and the other two are pulling but like equally strong. Does that make any sense? I don't really know, but I really love lemon poppy seed scents. They're just like to die for. Okay, the next one here I have not smelled yet, but I really do want to smell because I think this scent is going to be awesome. And this one here is just orange juice cake. This is buttery pound cake with orange zest, base notes of vanilla, coconut, and caramel. Oh my gosh, this is zesty. This is so zesty. I was not expecting this to be this zesty and fresh. I was thinking it would be more of like a more subdued orange, like mixed in with that bakery, but this ain't playing around. Oh, this is not playing. This is like in your face, in your face. It's kind of what that one is, but I really like it. Yeah, it's really good. You can smell all that stuff. You can smell the vanilla. I don't smell coconut. Well, I don't smell coconut. I think I can smell caramel. That's really good. That's not like a super obvious orange bakery scent. It's like zesty orange with some bakery notes and some lemon or whatever. I kind of really like that one. Okay, this next one here is pink juicy lemons. Sorry, there it is right there. I haven't been showing the tarts. Oh, that one's got, no, that's just got some, that's not oil. That's just like some scratches and stuff in there. Oh, this is so good. This is just their juicy lemon scent with pink sugar. Really, really good. I would say that this lemon is like 60% cleaner lemon, 40% fresh lemon. It's very, very like eye-opening, you know, kind of lemon. And mixed with that pink sugar, so good. Pink sugar plays so well with like fruit scents. Just, oh, to die for. Okay, this next one is pink key lime waffle cone. This is pink sugar, key lime pie, and waffle cone. So I thought this would be kind of an interesting blend. That is interesting. It's good interesting, though. You get the pink sugar. You get, like, that crispness and that zestiness of the lime scent in here. Tempered with, like, a back note of, like, all of the waffle cone scent and whatever else is going on in that key lime pie. And why is my camera not focusing on this? It's good. It's good. But definitely one of those eye-opening limes. So if you're looking for like a really mild lime scent, I would say that one probably is not for you. Okay, this next one I think is Pink Lemon Noel. Looking at the color, yep, Pink Lemon Noel. This is fresh lemons, pink sugar, and vanilla bean Noel. I like this lemon better. So I like the fresh lemon better than the juicy lemon. This is a little bit more smooth. This does smell more like a fresh lemon and less like a cleaner lemon. But definitely strongest on the lemon and then the pink sugar. The vanilla bean Noel, as I'm having the harder time smelling because those other two scents are just so very, very strong in that one. Okay, the next one I think is pink lime Noel. So yep, I had to get the lemon Noel and then I had to get the lime Noel because God knows I love my lime scent. So this is just pink sugar, fresh limes, and vanilla bean Noel. Once again, this is kind of same as the other one. This is a very good, fresh, zesty lime scent. And I can smell the pink sugar, but the lime is first, the pink sugar comes next. And the vanilla bean Noel, once again, in this one, I can smell it on cold, but it's definitely like, you know, like, I don't know what the official word is. It's definitely like at the end of what you're smelling, and then you can kind of like smell the lime. I mean, the vanilla bean Noel, but it's not like super obvious. Okay, this next one here is pink purple cows. This is purple cow along with pink sugar. Purple cow, I think, is grape mixed with vanilla ice cream. This one, I'm not so sure about. I've never had, you know, grape with a pink sugar scent, and maybe there's a reason why. Because you definitely get the grape first, but the pink sugar in here almost smells like, it's almost like a bitter aftertaste, because you initially get that like really good creamy grape scent, and then you get like the pink sugar at the end, and it's like, whoa, like what is that? Like what is that? You know what I'm saying? Like you're not expecting it in there. It's not like it's bad. It's just not, I would say that those two are not forming like a single blended scent together. It's like purple cow and pink sugar is like the little kid sister tagging along behind. That purple cow is like, I don't think I really want you here, but like, you know, our mom and dad said I gotta babysit you, so like I'm stuck with you, so sit in the corner. That's kind of what that one is, I would say. But it's interesting. I want to melt that one. Okay, the last one for this round here is a pink strawberry Noel. This is fresh strawberries, vanilla bean Noel, and pink sugar. Oh my goodness, I like this one. Smelling it right here. That is a really good strawberry scent. That is an exceptionally good fresh strawberry scent. Why do people not talk about her fresh strawberry scent more? This one is excellent. And it's very strong. It's stronger than the pink sugar. But pink sugar and strawberries to me play well together. This is like a blend I've had before or something similar to it. So this one is really good. This is probably so far in Code Sniff, one of my favorite ones of the order. Okay, you guys, so that's another 12 or so down. I've got another 2 rounds to go. So let me go set up for the next one. Alrighty, now moving on here. I got pumpkin cornbread. This one looks a little oily. No, it's not. I don't want to get oil over my hands again. So this one here is pumpkin cornbread. Ooh, this smells good. Sweet pumpkin blended with cornmeal, ground clove, and cinnamon. This smells real so good. Obviously, it's like spicy. Oh my goodness, and it does smell like corn, cornbread. That's a really good scent. That takes me straight to fall. Oh, so good. I really love fall scents and wax because that's last fall, 2013, is when I got into wax. So I just remember like joining and buying all this wax that was like, you know, pumpkin, caramel, apple, and leaves and woods and snow kind of scents. And I love it. I love the fall scents. This next one is Pumpkin Crunch Twinkies. I don't think I'm going to take this one out because I can see excess oil in this bag and I don't want to get my fingers all dirty again. This is Pumpkin Crunch and Twinkies. I don't know what Pumpkin Crunch is. Let me just give this a sniff. It smells really sweet. That's definitely a really sweet pumpkin scent, obviously with the Twinkies and everything like that. So that's what that one is. And I really do like a sweet pumpkin scent too. Okay, this next one here is Pumpkin Seed. And I know, it's kind of like weird. You would think like pumpkin seed, what is that supposed to be? Like, what's that smell like? You can't tell from the name. This one is Pumpkin Pie Spice and Vanilla Bean. Mmm. It's really good. This is another kind of like sweet pumpkin. Slightly spicy. And that vanilla in here kicks ass. I really like that one. I think I like this one a little bit more than the Pumpkin Crunch Twinkies. I'm going to have to start running myself some pumpkin. Okay, now I haven't really gone in good alphabetical order, and I'm realizing that the more and more I go. When I did my scent descriptions, I thought I did them alphabetically, but I obviously didn't. A, B, C, D. So anyways, they're a little bit off here. But this next one here is Purple Cow. Or maybe I'm still okay so far. This one is Purple Cow Ice Cream Scoop Dough Bread. Once again, Purple Cow is the grape ice cream scent. It's interesting. It's not what I thought it would smell like. It's kind of, it's a shade artificial overall. And that's immediately what I smell, and it kind of throws me off. This one smells different than the other one that I had with the Purple Cow with the pink sugar. Like, that Purple Cow smelled more like grape. This one just overall smells, smells a little funky. But I can smell the grape in there, though. When I do smell it. So I'm hope normally those kind of funky smells go away as it's getting melted, so I don't think that's gonna be a problem like once it's melted. This next one is Reindeer Poo. And I caught a whiff of this as I was sitting here messing about with the bags, and this one did smell really good. So this is a fragrance oil from Nature's Garden. This one is apples, pears, eucalyptus, pine, geranium, vanilla, cedarwood, and patchouli. So this sounds just like a really, really good one. And it is. It's absolutely refreshing. It's somehow refreshing and feminine and masculine at the same time. Probably a little bit more masculine. But it's just a really beautiful bedroom scent. And it's kind of funny because when I would, you know, reindeer poo, I don't know what I would think it would smell like. Like, would it be bakery? But it just smells so divinely amazing. This is really good. This is kind of like on par. I really love, Elf Sweat when it comes to holiday fragrances. But that one is also absolutely excellent. So that was a good find. Okay, this next one here is Rice Flour and Shea. Is that how you pronounce it? Shea, she, whatever. This is some Bath & Body Works dupe. This is fruits and flowers on an intense, alluring base of creamy vanilla. It's hard to smell on cold. There's not a lot of cold throw out of this, but it does smell very pretty. It's pretty, but it's not like overly feminine, like rose or jasmine or like one of those kinds of flowers that's really potent. It's kind of like a more delicate floral scent. And I think the addition of the, what was that in there? Vanilla in here is kind of nice. It's kind of nice. It kind of gives it a little bit more of like that creamy base note or something. Not more than just a straight floral scent. Okay, speaking of florals, this next one here is Stargazer Lily. This is reminiscent of a garden in full bloom. I guess this is a dupe of a Yankee Candle fragrance. It has florals with woods and light fruit notes. This one just has... So there are certain florals that I can detect rose, jasmine, honeysuckle. There may be a couple more out there that I can smell. This has like that smell of like just a really pretty but somewhat generic like floral fragrance that I'm not exactly sure if it's supposed to smell like a specific flower or if it just kind of smells like a lot of flowers. So they said this is reminiscent of a spring garden in bloom, although it's called Stargazer Lily. So I don't know if it's supposed to smell like a garden or like a lily, but Either way, it's got a really pretty floral fragrance. But this almost reminds me, I've said this in a video a long time ago. I used to have, when I was younger and had a Barbie, I must have had like some kind of cheap Barbie perfume or something. I remember my Barbie smelling like what that smells like. And that kind of floral note always reminds me of like a very like girlish floral note. It takes me like right back to childhood. I don't know what that was that I remember smelling. Okay, this next one here is strawberry zucchini. So take me, taking it right back to bakery. This is sweet strawberry and zucchini bread. I like this. Okay, so this is, I think, one of the first ones I've had with just zucchini in it. So I know earlier I said the grandma zucchini blends were creamy and the zucchini blends without the grandma are supposed to be more spicy. Yeah, and this one is spicier. I know I like spicy zucchini bread, so I actually think I like this more than the grandma's blends. I like it when it has a bit of a kick. And that one definitely does. I can smell the strawberry in there, but the strawberry is not that strong compared to the zucchini bread. The zucchini bread in there is super strong. Okay, this next one here is strawberry waffle cone Twinkies. And this one is sweet strawberries, waffle cone, and Twinkies. I'm not going to take this out because there's oil in here. I can already see it. Oh, this one is absolutely divine. This is super sweet, super creamy, sweet strawberry all the way. Absolutely. Just bakery sweet heaven. That one is an absolute winner. That's an excellent, excellent strawberry. And they are right on the money that that is a sweet strawberry scent. That is not a fresh picked strawberry scent. This next one here is sunflower. Now, Yankee Candle has a scent called Sunflower that I really do love. Now, I don't know if this is a dupe for that Yankee Candle scent or if she just calls it Sunflower. So this is described as a green floral bouquet with rose, orange flower, and jasmine. No, I'm pretty sure this is not the Yankee Candle Sunflower. This is absolutely jasmine dominant. And I can't smell the rose. Orange flower, I'm not exactly sure what that smells like, but that is definitely a more potent floral scent. Not like that Stargazer Lily, which is kind of a bit more generic. That one you can detect the individual floral scents. Okay, this next one here is Sweet Jasmine Vine. This is jasmine, honeysuckle, and orange blossom. So this one should also probably be potent. It's potent, but it's actually not as potent as the sunflower. That one kind of hit me in the nose more. This is a little bit more creamy and this one smells a lot more like straight up honeysuckle. Oh yeah, I think it's definitely stronger on the honeysuckle than the jasmine or the orange blossom in there, but yeah, it's a little bit less in your face than the sunflower. Okay, the last one for, not the haul, but the last one for this segment here is a sweet pumpkin bread. And this is pumpkin puree blended with clove, cinnamon, nutmeg, sugar, cornmeal, and ginger. Oh, this is another one that is a winner. And compared to the other pumpkin scents that I had, this one is definitely on the spicy side. This is definitely a spicy pumpkin scent. It's really good though. It's absolutely delicious. Like I said, once again, these pumpkin ones are taking me back to fall. Okay, I got like another 12 to go, so I'll be back again. All right, you guys, we're in the home stretch here. This is where it gets really out of alphabetical order. So I don't know like what I was doing. I think what I did is I had everything in alphabetical order. And then after I ordered, I saw a couple other ones that caught my eye and I just started throwing them in and I got all disorganized. So this next one here is Twilight in the Woods in the scallop again. Oh, this one got smushed. Look at him. He's all busted up. This one is, let's see here. Patchouli, sandal trees. Wait, what the heck? Mandarin balm, tangelo, eucalyptus, jungle moss, patchouli, sandal tree, redwood forest, amber glow, and musk. There's a lot in here. It's gorgeous. It's a it's like what a wood would smell like in my dreams. So this does not necessarily smell like an authentic forest scent, but it's like if kind of like if you were like a fairy and like a fairy wood. It's kind of like what that would smell like. Does that make any sense? It's like a wood scent, but it's just extremely pretty. And it just smells, oh, it just smells divine. I really don't know how else to describe it. This next one here is vanilla bean zucchini bread. This one is just vanilla bean Noel and zucchini bread. Once again, I would definitely want to smell this one because I think I'm digging her zucchini bread. I like it. I love spicy zucchini breads. I'm sorry, you guys. I think 95% of the people that like zucchini bread seem to prefer creamy over spicy. No, I think this kicks creamy zucchini bread's ass any day. This is good stuff. That's so good. And like that vanilla bean noel just gives it like the right amount of like sweetness and like a little bit of bakery note. Isn't there bakery in vanilla bean noel? You know, one of these days I need to look up the actual scent description for vanilla bean noel. Because I actually don't really know what's in there. Okay, this next one is vanilla pumpkin sugar cookie. This is vanilla pumpkin and sugar cookie. And I'm not going to take this out because this one, if I don't know if you guys can see, this one definitely has a lot of oils in it. So I'm not putting my fingers in there right now. But let me smell it. That is definitely one of the sweeter pumpkins I've ever smelled. Very sweet. That's a good sugar cookie scent. I can smell the sugar cookie in there. It's really nice. I'm digging that one. Okay, this next one here is Toasted Pink Twinkies. This is her toasted marshmallow, pink sugar, and Twinkies. Oh, really good. Really good. I mean, I love pink sugar when you put it with marshmallow. It's kind of like a standard blend. I think the addition of the Twinkies makes it even like a slightly bit less potent on the pink sugar, a little bit more creamy. That is a really good one. Really, really good, you guys. Okay, this next one here is strawberry preserves. I think this one is strong because when I was over here screwing with the bags, oh yeah, this one's strong because I can smell it right now. This is sweet ripened strawberries with notes of raw sugarcane. I don't really like it. There's something in here that just makes it smell like artificial. It smells like artificial, like Hershey strawberry, you know, like that little squeegee thing of strawberry that you can like put in milk and on ice cream and stuff. That's kind of what it smells like. I mean, it's not like it's bad, but it's definitely not, it doesn't smell like actual strawberries. It doesn't even smell like a sweet strawberry. Yeah, there's something in there. Now, what I would want to do is I probably would never want to melt this on its own, but I would blend that. I would take like half a scallop, like maybe try to cut it and blend it with something else. Because I think it would be kind of nice if I tried to tone it down a little bit, but just on its own, it's a little bit much. This next one here is Toasted Key Lime Marshmallow Noel. This is Toasted Marshmallow Key Lime Pie Vanilla Bean Noel. Really good. Once again, she's got a kick-ass key lime pie. Definitely, like I said, I've said this a million times, definitely a very zesty lime scent. So if you're looking for like a creamy, mild key lime pie, that one ain't it. That's zesty for sure. This one is a Raspberry Zinger. Zinger Twinkies. So Raspberry Zinger is raspberry, toasted coconut, buttercream frosting, and yellow sponge cake. And you got the Twinkies in there too. The coconut in here is strong. So you wouldn't necessarily know that there was coconut in here unless you knew what was in Raspberry Zinger. But yeah, beware. There is coconut in this. I can't really smell strawberry because all I can smell right now is coconut. Coconut and then sweet scents from the cake scent and the buttercream icing scent. But yeah. That one's got some coconut in it. That is a fact. Okay, this next one here is marmalade spiced zucchini bread. And this one is zucchini bread with marmalade spice. Really good. This one is super spicy because that marmalade spice, I don't know what's in there, but obviously that must be spicy. And then the zucchini bread is kind of spicy. But it's good. It's not overwhelmingly marmalade. So marmalade is what? Like oranges? Like orange jelly jam stuff. Is that what marmalade is? So when I smell this, I don't detect a single like fruit note that really pops out at me. But it is, you can detect some kind of, you can detect, I think, like a slight citrus note out of there in general. But definitely the spicy note hits first overall, and then the zucchini bread scent hits next. Okay, the last bag here, not that this is the last thing, but the last bag is toasted caramel zucchini. This is Kickin' Caramel Toasted Marshmallow Zucchini Bread. This one's really good. I love caramel scents. They're just to die for. And I think mixed with that spicy zucchini, it's really good. And I like it with the spicy zucchini. I don't know if I would think caramel with the creamy zucchini. Just, it's not as interesting to me. I like it with that little bit of spice. Okay, so out of all of the bags that I have shown, three of those bags and the scallops were part of the free stuff. I don't remember at this time which ones of these were the free ones. Now, in addition to the three free bag of scallops, there also were the two bags of brittle that were absolutely free. So you had to put in the comment section like what you wanted. So this is one that I got, and I got this one in lemon noel. And let me see if I can put the camera up. Oh no, put the camera up a little bit so you guys can see better. Oh, straighten that up. Yeah, so anyways, this is Lemon Noel. So what this one is Lemon Chiffon and Vanilla Bean Noel. Now, I don't know what is in Lemon Chiffon at all. These are big pieces of bread on me. Look at that. You can, like, stab somebody with that. Where's my cat Sam? Stab, stab. With the brittle. This is definitely a super... So once again, if I'm going between my tug of war in my mind, this is a tug of war between a cleaner lemon and a fresh lemon. And to me, this is like... Fresh lemon is winning, but barely over cleaner lemon. It's a very, like, eye-widening, bright lemon scent. And it is a little bit surprising because that thing is definitely potent. And the Vanilla Bean Noel in here definitely takes a backseat to that very fresh lemon scent. So this Lemon Noel is pretty much just like a really bright lemon scent. But that's cool with me. I love bright lemon scents. That's definitely not a problem. I love that. And then this last one that I got here in my bag, this is Mrs. Claus's Pink Noel Cookies. This is... Mrs. Claus's cookies, oh, pink sugar and Vanilla Bean Noel. I think I got something really similar to this in a bag. Oh no, that was zucchini bread. Yeah, so this is a pink sugar cookies and Vanilla Bean Noel. And once again, look at these like ginormous brittle pieces. And ooh, okay, you can kind of get them like that. I really like this one. I really, really like it. Oh, it's really good. You can kind of pick up all of them in here. The cookies, the pink sugar, and the Vanilla Bean Noel. All kind of like equally strong. That's a really good bud. I had a feeling I would like that one when I was looking at the scent description, which is why I asked for this one in the bag instead of in a scallop or anything like that, because I had a feeling that that one was going to be good. Okay, you guys, so that's it. So I imagine this video in all is ending up at like the 40 to 45 minute point. So my apologies. I was going to break it up into two videos, but like at that point, does it really make a difference if it's two separate videos versus one? I mean, it's the same amount of time, even though mentally maybe it's like easier to digest when it's two separate videos. I'm not really sure. But yeah, this was my huge Haley's Heavenly Scents order from the sale. And like I said, I have another sale order coming that looks like it's got about 26 more bags of stuff. It's about half this size, I think for the second order I made it barely over that $100 point where I needed to get the free stuff. This one was a little bit more than that, but anyways, I really hope you guys watched it. I hope that if you put this on when you were cleaning, you know, or one of those days you need background noise, that this video served a purpose, and maybe you heard a scent in one of these lots of scents that piqued your interest, and maybe you go check it out. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this. I'll catch you on the next video. Bye.